welcome to a very special event celebrating the FXX original series, You're the Worst.
Hello? Damn it, not again.
You should just get on Jimmy's plan. He gets great reception, and a family plan will probably be cheaper for both of you anyway.
Ew,
why don't you get on a family plan?
This atypical romantic comedy is about a toxic relationship in a world of self-absorbed people.
Jimmy!
What?
Where's the Bloody Mary bar?
What the hell?
Edgar!
Edgar!
It's Sunday, right? Edgar!
Edgar!
We asked why this series strikes a chord with audiences.
People don't want a fairy tale anymore. They want the truth. They want those awkward bedroom moments. I think people can relate to those kind of things rather than this fairy tale world that I think we've seen a lot of.
The writers are so good, and they are good at sort of taking whatever seems to be happening in the world and expressing it in a new way. They just got their finger on something.
Why do I have to be the one making all the adjustments? How has your life changed since I moved in, other than you get all of this next to you every night?
Secretly, everyone thinks that they're too damaged to really be in a functional relationship. Our show hopes to show that we're all damaged and we all deserve love. We're just showing the most extreme version of two people who are complete and make terrible mistakes, and yet they still deserve love.
Do you think Paul wants his geocaching gear?
Maybe he can use it to track down his new girlfriend's tiny boobs.
Stephen Falk and the writers do a great job at telling the truth of how up we all are. They show the dark and twisted side without sacrificing the humanity.
We're able to really push the envelope, and we're finally getting to tell stories about people who normally don't get to see themselves on screen.
What's the first letter on the typewriter?
A.
Wrong. Q.
Q?
Q. Q?
Why Q?
It just says Q.
Why would Q be first?
Barely any words use Qs. Qs are like the elbows of letters.
What does that mean?
We're back at a very special event celebrating the FXX original series, You're the Worst.
What's the address here?
You don't know the address?
No.
You live here.
Who knows their address?
People? Kidnap children?
How does the show take traditional romantic comedy conventions and subvert them and turn them into something fresh?
One thing, by making them unlikable at the beginning. I don't think you'd ever start a romantic comedy with two really horrible people attempting a relationship. As soon as I tell people that's what the show's about, they're like, oh, I love it already.
Guess what Paul's definition of love is?
What?
Putting someone else's needs above yours.
Ew.
I know, he's such a gump.
It allows women to be many different things. Like, the Lindsay character can be ditzy and sexy and also unexpectedly smart and emotionally aware. You can kind of be everything, and the show allows us to do that.
Apparently, on Sundays, they have these sports bars full of horny macho dum-dums whose girlfriends are all at home. Plus wings.
The episode where it's revealed Gretchen has clinical depression, that's a reality in a lot of relationships, and I've never seen a sitcom portray that in the way it's portrayed in You're the Worst.
I'm sorry you don't feel anything, Gretchen.
Me too.
You have to be aware of what the cliches are. I'm a big fan of rom-coms, and at a certain point you start to go, oh, really, they're all just kind of following the same pattern. And then you have to watch yourself date and watch other people date and go, oh, we're all disgusting. Then you put that together and add a lot of alcoholism, and then you get a show like ours.
God save the queen.
God save the queen.
Defend your character and tell us why he is not the worst.
Well, I like to think of Edgar as the moral compass of the show. He may be a freeloading expat dealing with PTSD who used to be homeless and sell drugs at one point, but he's really just a romantic at heart that loves to cook and watch Rachel Ray.
At the end of each episode, I nearly cry. And that makes me a softie.
I'm proud if she is the worst. I'm not gonna make a case that she's not.
Can you please defend your character and tell me why she is not the worst?
Nope. After I cleaned the fries off your face and put you to bed, you said something to me that was pretty dark.
Oh, don't tell me.
Okay, I won't.
For FXM, I'm Tava Smiley. Thanks for watching.